In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
My dear brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins, and so prepare ourselves to celebrate the sacred mysteries. Lord Jesus, you healed the sick. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
You forgave sinners. Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
You gave yourself to heal us and bring us strength. Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Let us pray. Stir up your power, we pray, O Lord, and come, that with you to protect us, we may find rescue from the pressing dangers of our sins, and with you to set us free, we may be found worthy of salvation. Who live and reign with God the Father in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. Thus says the Lord God, but a very little while, and Lebanon shall be changed into an orchard, and the orchard be regarded as a forest. On that day the deaf shall hear the words of a book, and out of gloom and darkness the eyes of the blind shall see. The lowly will ever find joy in the Lord, and the poor rejoice in the Holy One of Israel. For the tyrant will be no more, and the arrogant will have gone. All who are alert to do evil will be cut off, those whose mere word condemns a man, who ensnare his defender at the gate, and leave the just man with an empty claim. Therefore thus says the Lord, the God of the house of Jacob, who redeemed Abraham, now Jacob shall have nothing to be ashamed of, nor shall his face grow pale, when his children see the work of my hands in his midst. They shall keep my name holy. They shall reverence the Holy One of Jacob, and be in awe of the God of Israel. Those who err in spirit shall acquire understanding, and those who find fault shall receive instruction. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The Lord is my light and my salvation.
The Lord is my light and my salvation.
The Lord is my light and my salvation. Whom should I fear? The Lord is my life's refuge. Of whom should I be afraid?
The Lord is my light and my salvation.
One thing I ask of the Lord, this I seek, to dwell in the house of the Lord all the days of my life, that I may gaze on the loveliness of the Lord and contemplate His temple.
The Lord is my light and my salvation.
I believe that I shall see the bounty of the Lord in the land of the living. Wait for the Lord with courage. Be stout-hearted and wait for the Lord.
The Lord is my light and my salvation. Please stand. Our Lord shall come with power. He will enlighten the eyes of His servants.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
As Jesus passed by, two blind men followed Him, crying out, "Son of David, have pity on us." When He entered the house, the blind men approached Him and said to them, "Do you believe that I can do this?" "Yes, Lord," they said to Him. Then He touched their eyes and said, "Let it be done for you according to your faith." And their eyes were opened. Jesus warned them sternly, "See that no one knows about this." But they went out and spread word of Him through all that land. The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ. Please be seated.
Some 7 years ago, there was this Filipino movie entitled Kita Kita, a love story that ended not so well and yet filled with romance and acceptance of each other's situation until the end. Kapag ka isinalin po natin siya sa English, it's translated as "I saw you, kita kita." They saw each other in their first meet, and they still embrace this experience of seeing each other, even though sickness and disabilities crossed over their paths in their life. In today's gospel, my dear brothers and sisters, we heard of Jesus being followed by two blind men. Nakita ni Jesus ang mga bulag na ito. And as if Jesus told them, "Nakita ko kayo, kita kita." But He saw this as an avenue for goodness. He saw this as a way to heal them. He gave them the sight that they've been longing for, or maybe the sight that they've been crying out for. But this action of Jesus is noteworthy. It was not selfish. He didn't settle by seeing them only. But he wanted this man to see him. Ang makita din nila si Jesus. As if, finally, this blind man can also tell Jesus, I can see you now too. Kita na din kita. And my dear brothers and sisters, this is the goodness of our Advent season. And at the same time, the goodness of God in our lives. Tiwala tayong nakikita tayo ng Diyos. Pero gusto din niyang makita natin siya. The eyes of our bodies and the eyes of our hearts will be beautiful doors for Him to see this loving God whom we wait and prepare for. If God sees us, I hope it is also our desire to see Him. Kung gusto ng Diyos na makita tayo, sana tayo din gusto nating makita siya at magpabukas ng ating mga mata sa mga panahon na ito. It is very hard to celebrate Christmas with hands filled with gifts, maybe with pockets filled with your bonus, with tummy filled with food, with heart and with memories filled with Christmas stories and gatherings, but without the eyes to look forward to see God. Baka bukas ang ilang parte ng katawan natin, but our eyes remain blind to see this loving God coming in our lives. Kung kaya po dumadating si Jesus sa araw-araw ng ating buhay, dahil nakikita niya tayong lahat sa ating mga gawain at alalahanin. Kung gusto tayong makita ng Diyos, masabi din natin sa Kanya, gusto ko ding makita kita. If Advent is a very good time to prepare for this blessed season of Christmas, may we not only settle with hearing Him or feeling Him. The Lord will open our eyes so that we can see Him and enjoy His face this blessed season we are looking forward to.
Please stand.
We ask God the Father to open our eyes so that we may follow Him wholeheartedly. For every petition we shall say, Lord, enlighten us.
Lord, enlighten us.
That the Church may be a credible witness to the Gospel and be a sure guide to peace and solidarity. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, enlighten us.
That those in government offices be men and women of principles and integrity. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, enlighten us.
That like the two blind men, we may have firm confidence in Jesus and follow Him on the path of life. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, enlighten us.
That those who are suffering from failing eyesight or blindness may overcome their difficulties and find total healing. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, enlighten us.
That our deceased relatives and friends may be granted perpetual light and eternal rest. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, enlighten us.
Let us pray in silence for our own intentions as we lift up to the Lord all the intentions offered in this Mass and our prayers for one another. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, enlighten us.
Father in heaven, fill us with your love and dispel the darkness from our lives, so that we may work in the light of Christ your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the Holy Spirit forever and ever.
Amen. Please be seated. Please stand.
Pray, dearly beloved, that my sacrifice and yours may be acceptable to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Be pleased, O Lord, with our humble prayers and offerings, and since we have no merits to plead our cause, come, we pray, to our rescue with the protection of your mercy, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Lord, the Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For he assumed at his first coming the lowliness of human flesh, and so fulfilled the design you formed long ago, and opened for us the way to eternal salvation, that when he comes again in glory and majesty, and all is at last made manifest, we who watch for that day may inherit the great promise in which now we dare to hope. And so with angels and archangels, with thrones and dominions, and with all the hosts and powers of heaven, we sing the hymn of your glory as without end we acclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. Please kneel.
You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread, and giving thanks, broke it, and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice, and once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me."
Please stand.
The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Jose, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy, welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles, with Saint Nicholas and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, informed by divine teaching, we dare to say, Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil.
Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, "Peace I leave you, my peace I give you," look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other the sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace. Please kneel.
Behold the Lamb of God. Behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Please stand.
Let us pray. Replenished by the food of spiritual nourishment, we humbly beseech you, O Lord, that through our partaking in this mystery, you may teach us to judge wisely the things of earth and hold firm to the things of heaven. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
And may Almighty God bless you, the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Our celebration has been offered. Go forth in the peace and love of Christ.
Thanks be to God.